This video is brought to you by Thermo Fisher Scientific. Offering a wide range of reagents and materials, Thermo Fisher supports virtually every laboratory application, from research to drug discovery and development to manufacturing. With over 80,000 laboratory chemicals now on one site, Thermo Fisher delivers choice, quality, and supply assurance for all your chemical needs. Visit the link below for more information.
He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
We have learned a lot together on this channel regarding general chemistry and organic chemistry, but we have focused predominantly on concept-based learning rather than practical knowledge. While it is certainly extremely important to understand what molecules are and how they behave on a conceptual level, one can never have a true understanding of chemistry until they get into the laboratory and do some chemistry themselves. In this series, we will take the chemistry we have learned together and see exactly how it can be applied in order to do empirical science. We will learn how to perform chemical reactions, as well as a variety of analytical techniques. We will learn how to interpret data and solve problems. Since doing chemistry requires a wide variety of specialized instrumentation, this series will be most useful for undergraduate students and advanced high school students who are taking chemistry courses with laboratory components for the first time. Together, we will discuss the most commonly performed techniques in such courses so that you can approach your assignments with clarity and confidence. But even those who are not formally studying chemistry may find this series worth watching, as it is fascinating to learn about the precise methods we use to discern knowledge about the molecular world. How can we know the identity of a substance on the molecular level? How do we know when a chemical reaction is finished? How do we perform chemistry that is air sensitive? Once a competency in the laboratory is gained, a grander context for chemical knowledge opens up like an oyster, and an appreciation for the astounding contributions of the chemists who came before you becomes apparent. Whatever your intent is in learning about chemistry laboratory techniques, it goes without saying that my general chemistry, and in some cases my organic chemistry tutorials, are a prerequisite for this content. We will not be pausing to deliver lectures about conceptual topics. It will be presumed that the relevant areas of chemistry are already well understood. And indeed, if they are not, most of these tutorials will be quite perplexing, although potentially still entertaining, as we will be using a lot of neat gadgets and gizmos. But be sure to do the necessary review prior to watching, including my lecture-based tutorials on laboratory techniques such as extraction, chromatography, and distillation. In this series, we will be performing these techniques firsthand, but the earlier tutorials will still be extremely useful for context. And once we get through these simple and ubiquitous techniques that all students must learn, we will begin to examine some more niche practices within the organic chemistry laboratory, including a few important synthetic techniques we have learned together. By the way, since I do not personally have access to a laboratory any longer, these techniques will be performed by friend to the channel, Jamal Muhoza. Wave hello to the nice people, Jamal. Jamal is an assistant professor of biochemistry at the University of Arkansas. He does chemistry every day, so he certainly knows his way around a laboratory, and he will have plenty of wisdom to dispense in helping to produce this content. So, without further delay, let's learn how to do chemistry.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.